Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for Autumn 2020. After an extremely dry start to summer, rain in mid-January and early February brought some relief. Autumn is likely to be warmer and possibly drier than average in the north, while some areas may be wetter in the south. But first, let's look at recent conditions. Summer across southern Australia saw several individual hot days. In contrast, northern Australia had persistent heat even after the monsoon arrived. Temperatures in the Northern Territory and Queensland were 5 to 7 degrees above average in early February, and the Northern Territory had its hottest February night on record, 27.3 degrees on the 15th. Turning to rainfall, the monsoon began about 3 weeks late, one of the later monsoon onsets since records began in 1957. Northern Australia has now had low rainfall for the last two wet seasons. Four tropical cyclones have brought some rainfall to Australia, Damien and Esther in February and Blake and Claudia in January. Heavy rainfall and severe storms also affected eastern parts of the country during February, but heaviest falls were generally east of the Divide. Rains have increased soil moisture in many areas. While soils in southwest Western Australia generally remain dry, significant increases occurred down the east coast. Any further rainfall in these areas now has a better chance of resulting in runoff and contributing to water storages. Sydney's storages increased to 81% over the past month, but water storages in the northern Murray-Darling Basin have only risen slightly. In the north, the late monsoon onset has seen the Darwin River Dam at 54%, the lowest level since December 2009. But despite the rains, around 30% of Australia and 90% of New South Wales still have serious and severe rainfall deficiencies. So what will influence our climate in the coming months? Our major climate drivers are currently neutral and look to stay that way over autumn. However, warm ocean temperatures around northern Australia, which typically help increase rain, are being offset by warm temperatures in the tropical Pacific that would normally draw moisture away from Australia. As a result, autumn rainfall could be below average over some parts of the tropical north, but likely to be above average for areas of western and south Australia. Low stream flows are likely for most forecast locations. However, recent rains and wetter catchments mean around 30% of locations are expected to have median to high flows, particularly in northern and some of the eastern regions. With warm oceans around northern Australia, autumn temperatures are very likely to remain warmer than average in most states. Only southern parts of Western Australia and the southeast may be closer to average. So in summary, autumn is likely to see a chance of drier conditions in the tropical north, but wetter in parts of the south. Warmer than average days and nights, and some stream flows are likely to return to near normal levels. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about the outlooks on our website. We'll see you next time.